for DeMarco's Rant.
DeMarco's Rant.
Why the f*** you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my God. Stop lying.
Hey, I'm just telling you how I feel. DeMarco comes real.
I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take this anymore.
I'm not gonna let your false narratives against me go unchallenged. DeMarco comes real.
Right here, right now.
On the iPower Evening Show.
iPower Evening Show. Today is Tuesday, May 15th, 2018. It's time for my rant debut. This is DeMarco Comes Real, meaning this is the real me when it comes to my true feelings on how I see people, whether in the news, in entertainment, in sports, how I see society, politics, our communities, our cities, the United States, and the world. Today's rant is on Kanye West. I once respected this man after his accident, where people were praying for his speedy recovery. This is the same Kanye West that supported and was a big advocate for black women at one time. Also represented the black community in the South Side of Chicago and supporting his people who were in the struggle. But that has all changed. And I don't want to say that it was the death of his mother back in 2008 that fully changed Kanye West to who he is today compared to the old Kanye West before his mother's passing. I say when he first met Kim Kardashian and they started falling in love with each other and having kids, that's what changed everything. And correct me if I'm wrong, but wasn't it Kanye West that said on live national television right after Hurricane Katrina in New Orleans in 2005 that then President George W. Bush does not care about black people? Didn't he say that? Yes, he did. Even actor Mike Myers, Dr. Evil himself, was standing next to Kanye at that time and was like, huh? Well, not no more, ladies and gentlemen. Kanye West has done showed his true colors when he met Orange 45 at the Trump Towers after he won the 2016 presidential election against Hillary. But before Kanye did all that with Orange 45, he was mad at Jay-Z because according to Kanye, Jay-Z left him high and dry when he was going through his breakdown and mental issues. Tried to embarrass the man, Jay-Z, at his performance in 2016, causing Kanye to cancel the remaining of his concert events. First of all, Jay-Z is a grown-ass man. He had Beyonce to focus on and his daughter, Blue Ivy. Second of all, for you to support Orange 45 in the Oval Office was no surprise to me. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Kanye West, or I should say Kanye West, has joined the likes of Diamond and Silk, the Trump Girls, Stacey Dash, Pastor Darryl Scott, and I'm pretty sure that this put a smile on the evil faces of Sean Hannity and Laura Ingraham of Fox News, saying, "We now own Kanye." Well, you can have Kanye. Keep him. Because as far as I'm concerned, I could care less about Kanye because he was a confused Negro. And to add insult to injury, when he went on TMZ saying that slavery was a choice, I got a problem with that. Most black people got a problem with that because slavery was not a choice, Kanye. But thank God Van Lathan, a brother from TMZ, set Kanye straight on slavery. Kanye has that Negropean mindset of a conservative Republican. And now that these white conservatives like Rush Limbaugh and other radio conservatives are saying, Kanye is now a patriotic American. Really? Since when? Now, all of a sudden, Kanye is a patriotic American, but it wasn't like that before when he said, back in 2005, George W. Bush does not care about black people. So now he's a true conservative, a true Republican, a true patriotic American. Now notice how Kanye is now going after President Obama, going after Snoop Dogg. And as of right now, just like how Detroit is not playing your music, I cannot play Kanye's music at this time and probably no time soon. After he done showed his true colors on how he sees Trump as quote unquote his boy and how he threw his own black people, African Americans, under the bus. Now maybe him as a feature of other hip hop artists when he was the old Kanye West. but not him as the main focus, part of the Kardashians. And ever since Kanye has came out for Trump in 2016 and a conservative Republican, Kanye has lost over 6 million followers on Twitter. Kama is a bitch. Oh well. And that is my rant, ladies and gentlemen.
The iPower Evening Show.